Welcome to Around the Panhandle with TV10, a Hornby Media Group production. I'm your host, Colin McLaughlin. We will be exploring things to do, places to go, and people to know throughout the Eastern Panhandle. This episode features King Street Coffee and Tobacco Emporium. The store is at 320 West King Street in Martinsburg and is owned by Edward Trout. There's a plethora of premium cigars, tobaccos, pipes, coffees, and teas for sale. Also, King Street Coffee and Tobacco Emporium is the only public place in the county where you can smoke inside. I asked Ed why he opened up the store, what are the differences between cigars, and so much more. Here's what he had to say.
When I was in high school, I worked for a shop downtown. It was called Old Berkeley Tobaccos. And they were mainly a convenience store, but they also sold some pipe tobaccos and a few cigars. And I enjoyed the product. I really enjoyed the social aspect of the product. And as I got through with college, I decided that I wanted to have a shop like that. There, you don't see many shops these days. Like, it used to be the hardware store was always the place where people would gather and have a nice conversation or have some social interaction, and a lot of that's gone away. So I feel like the cigars and the coffee, they lend themselves to that. So that was one of the big draws to the business for me. So I focused on the premium cigars, the pipe tobaccos, and the coffees, and kind of left the convenience store on the side. I would probably say the Arturo Fuente has been one of the most popular cigars that I've sold over the years. The family has been in the cigar business for several years, multiple generations. It's a Dominican product, so it's approachable to a lot of people. It's a mild to medium strength, and they have several different lines, several different levels. This in particular is one of my favorites. It has the Dominican filler, but it has a little darker wrapper, a sun-grown wrapper. So it gives it a little more flavor, a little spice and pepper, a little earthiness. So it's not as heavy as some others can be, but that sun-grown wrapper provides a little bit of additional strength to it. One of the cigars that Arturo Fuente has been extremely well known for is their Opus X line. It is a little more full-bodied, a little richer than a lot of traditional Dominicans. This cigar was very unique when it first came out into the market. It was one of the first that was 100% Dominican tobacco, so what they call a puro, meaning that all the tobacco that's in the cigar, that's comprised of the cigar, is all from one country, Dominican Republic. They were able to grow a specific wrapper, a Corojo strain of wrapper that was hard to grow in the Dominican Republic. They were able to get that perfected to where they were able to use it for the wrapper. So it's been a very interesting product and has stayed one of the more popular and more sought after cigars on the market. There's traditionally three components to a premium cigar. There's the filler, which is the majority of the tobacco, and those are, in a premium cigar, those are a whole long leaf that's been bunched together. And then they put a binder around that, which is the second part of the cigar construction, and then it's put into a mold where it's held that shape for a little while. And then the last component is the outside, the wrapper on the outside of it, which is traditionally the most expensive component of the cigar, the wrapper tobacco. They really look for that to be blemish-free. They look for it to be uniform in color, and it actually adds a little bit more of the flavor to the overall profile. Even though the wrapper may only be 5 or 10% of the cigar, if you take, like, say, maybe a heavier filler but you put a lighter wrapper on it, it'll actually smooth out the flavor of the cigar. So sometimes when I'm recommending cigars to people, I'll have them get the same cigar but with a couple different types of wrappers, whether it be a natural or what they call Maduro, which is a heat cured or a fermented wrapper, or, like I mentioned earlier, that sun-grown wrapper. So I may have people get the same cigar but with different wrappers to it, and then that way any difference in flavor that they get from the different cigars is coming strictly from the wrapper. The primary producing regions, I mentioned Dominican Republic, Nicaragua, and Honduras are the other two of the three large producing regions. Cuban cigars have been going back and forth. Right now they are illegal again. In years past, they had actually opened up relations with Cuba. So if you traveled to another country, say somewhere in the Caribbean or Canada, you were legally allowed to bring them back. Now that has been restricted again. So now, as of today, Cuban cigars are illegal to bring into the country. I typically have cigar events here in the shop during the spring and summer months. With COVID, we've had to cancel or restrict a lot of those events. We've done a lot of like kind of more like in-store, like month-long promotions. I hope if we get back to a lower infection rate where maybe it's a little safer for people to gather, that I'll be able to do these in-store cigar events again. And they typically are done 3 or 4 hours during a day. We'll have a salesman here. We'll have specials on the products. We'll have giveaways, raffles, prizes. So I would really like to get back to those. I really look forward to those. It's just another example of the social aspect that I love so much about this business and this shop. I was very fortunate to be able to stay open. Coffee shops were one of the types of businesses that the governor allowed to stay open in his executive orders. And I think cigars were maybe a thing that people leaned on a little bit last year. It was a stressful time for people. They were anxious. I feel like they were able to use that cigar maybe to calm down a little bit, maybe to find a little bit of calm and peace in a time when things got pretty chaotic. There's not many places to smoke, especially in public. It is one of the only places. This cigar shop is actually the only place that you can smoke in public in the county. The only exemption from the county's smoking ordinance, smoking restrictions, is a retail tobacco shop. And this shop is the only shop in the county that fits their restrictive guidelines for tobacco shop. I feel like in these days where you can obviously get cigars online, you can buy cigars through mail order, you're going to miss that personal experience to be able to come in, to be able to smell the cedar, look at the cigar, touch the cigar, and also be able to get a lot of advice and a lot of questions answered that you might not be able to get online. You'll notice we're in this room. This room is humidified. It's temperature controlled. It stays between 65% to 70% of humidity and temperature at all times. You're not going to get that from a big warehouse, big mail order box store. If you want to come in and say you've seen this cigar online before, but you'd like to try one of them, you can come in, you can buy one of those at a time. Whereas traditionally when you're mail order shopping, you have to buy a box of something at a time. So to buy 20 or 25 of something to realize that you just don't like that cigar. Whereas here you can come in, you can buy 10 cigars, they could all be a different cigar. As far as cigar smokers go, we're probably in the best time that we have ever been in. There's more types of tobacco that's being used, more blends that are being put together every day that previously were not available. But the biggest thing that I would say is I would just appreciate, I feel very fortunate that my customers have supported me like they have over the last 27, 28 years I've been in business. Like I say, a local shop like this, you're just going to get that personalized service that you're not going to get anywhere else.
So whether you just want a place to relax and be social, get a premium cigar to de-stress, or say hello to Carlos the Cat, make sure to visit King Street Coffee and Tobacco Emporium, located at 320 West King Street in Martinsburg. You can also call them at 304-264-9130 or visit them online at www.kingstreetemporium.com. The Emporium is open Monday through Saturday from 10 a.m. to 6 p.m.